Hey, Gazelia here. So today I wanted to show you some of the shrubs that are blooming in the garden right now. And I know we love our perennials and spring bulbs and annuals, and all of the affection seems to go towards them. But shrubs are incredibly important in the garden, and they provide the sort of structure like nothing else can. And most of them have multiple seasons of interest, like this viburnum behind me. So this viburnum is called Viburnum plicatum variety tomentosum. I am not certain of the cultivar because I bought this shrub about 12 years ago, and that was before my very careful record keeping in the garden. It's probably Mariaceae, which is quite common with this Viburnum plicatum variety tomentosum. But again, don't quote me on that. And this shrub is truly beautiful. It has a gorgeous structure in the winter. And then around mid-May time in my zone 6, northern New Jersey, it has these beautiful flowers. They're lace cap shaped flowers. The middle has fertile flowers, and the outer edge has the infertile flowers. And those fertile flowers in the middle start setting berries around August, September time in my zone. And then birds get them. They probably last about a month before birds get them completely. And in the fall, it has a gorgeous fall color. It's sort of a dark burgundy, light burgundy, depends on the year, of course. And then the process repeats again, you know, in the winter, beautiful structure, in the spring, the flowers, in the summer, it has this sort of a wall of a green. So this is a great privacy plant if you have space for it. This plant gets to about 15 feet wide and 15 feet tall. So it's a lot of times more spread out horizontally than vertically. So keep that in mind. And I planted this shrub when it was just a baby, about 4 or 5 feet tall, about 12 years ago. So keep in mind, this is what it looks like after years of growth. And a lot of times I show you something I just planted and you don't quite see the maturity. So this is a mature shrub, and make sure wherever you plant it, it has the space to acquire that beautiful shape that it has. So just a quick side note about other viburnums. There are so many viburnums out there, and this spring I'm really into viburnums. But there is a Viburnum plicatum, which is a lot of times called snowball viburnum, and it has only the infertile flowers, and the flower inflorescence looks like a ball, like a baseball. And because those flowers are infertile, they don't really seed around. Meanwhile, this one, it does set berries, and there is a possibility for it to be somewhat seedy. It never seeded in my garden, and it is not invasive in my area, but with any exotic plant, it is better to check online whether it is invasive in your area and make sure that it's not going to invade local forests or harm the environment. But so far so good in my zone. But speaking of natives, I have a beautiful native shrub right here on my right, which is Calycanthus floridus, or Old Spice. And it has these beautiful maroon flowers, very unusual. They are fragrant, and actually the leaves are fragrant as well when you crush them. There are different varieties of the shrub as well. There are some hybrids with the Asian species, but this is the straight American native species here. And I just absolutely love it. So we used to have a holly right here in front of me where I'm talking. So it was shading out a lot of this shrub, and most of the flowers are on top. But now that the holly is gone, I could see there's a lot of growth coming out from the bottom. So it will fill in a lot. This shrub is so carefree, you guys. If you're looking for something that can grow in the sun, part shade, shade, and has this loose, very natural looking structure, just a beautiful, beautiful shrub. Since I'm standing here, I actually have a winter gem boxwood that I just put in this pot because I had nothing else here. It has this just a nice architectural feature in this beautiful corner that I have here. This is a Miss Kim lilac that is about to bloom. It hasn't bloomed, but it has tons of buds, and it's probably going to bloom in a couple of weeks. Now, right behind me, a lot of people ask what kind of conifer is this. Now, this is Thuja occidentalis yellow ribbon. I finally found the name. I've been looking for it for a while. This Thuja or arborvitae is about 10 years old. So it's very slow growing variety. We bought it as a baby. It was about 3 feet tall, but now it has this beautiful structure and beautiful yellow tinge to it. So it adds a lot of color to this composition when nothing else blooms. But even when nothing else blooms, it has this beautiful textures, beautiful structure. I am working on the flower garden right in front of it, so it will have a lot of layers. If you want to see the space in the fall, we did a video last October of November, I'm not certain, but it will show you the type of fall colors that this space has. Another beautiful shrub that I have blooming in the garden right now is this Rhododendron Solidarity. And it starts out with more of a red buds like that and opens up to a deep pink flowers like this, and they fade to a very light pink like that. Now, I bought this rhododendron in a rare find nursery in South Jersey. They have tons of interesting rhododendrons and azaleas. And interesting thing about this particular rhododendron is that it tops out at about 4 to 5 feet. So it's not one of those giant rhododendrons that grow to 8 or 10 feet. So if you're looking for a smaller rhododendron for a shady spot, this is a good choice. I only get about 1 hour of sunlight in this area. As you can see, I planted it together with hostas and some ferns, some hakinakloa. And by the way, the tulips are still here. I know I keep showing it to you guys, but they are still blooming. Quick note about rhododendrons. Obviously, they need acidic soil, and my soil is about at 5.6 pH, which is pretty acidic, so they're very happy in my place. If you have more of an alkaline soil, you may have to either grow these in pots, but still you have to deal with your water, because a lot of times water in alkaline areas is also alkaline. So, you know, it's tricky, but if you have more of an acidic soil, they just love it. Another azalea rhododendron, azaleas are technically rhododendrons, that I have here is this Trilite azalea. This is a deciduous azalea, so it does lose its leaves in the winter, but in the spring it has these beautiful, delicate flowers that are very unusual in color. It has little pink, little yellow. By the way, I see a caterpillar enjoying the leaves right now. Gotta deal with that. So deciduous azaleas are very interesting. I absolutely love them. There's a lot of varieties that are native to Mid-Atlantic or my area of New Jersey. Definitely going to expand my collection with those. And here we have azaleas blooming, and most of these azaleas I planted about 12 years ago with my parents, so they have a sentimental value to me. And as you can see, they can get quite large. Unfortunately, I do not know the cultivars of all of them except for the one on the right, which is Koromo Shikibu or Spider Azalea, which is one of the coolest ones I've ever seen, and I had to have it when I saw it in the nursery. Azaleas are pretty carefree shrubs in my area because, again, I have a pretty acidic soil and consistent moisture throughout the spring and summer. But when you establish, or after you plant azaleas and they are in the period of establishment, you should water them regularly. And after that, they're pretty drought tolerant shrubs. And a lot of people prune their azaleas into ball shape like shrubs. I like to leave them natural like this. They're just so romantic looking, and when they merge together with the neighboring shrubs, they just look like a beautiful tapestry of different colors. Anyway, this is it for today, guys. I just wanted to show you some of the beautiful shrubs that are blooming in the garden right now, and I hope you learned something new today, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.